Alrighty, hello guys, welcome your faces back to another video on my channel. Today we are back in Stormworks yet again, and today we're actually back with the half-track build. This right here is the engine that we have. This is a, 15-cylinder engine, which is massive. And we actually have the deck right here as well. So far, we actually have quite a lot of this already built. What we're going to do today is try and figure out how to build a, I guess the front of this thing. I think I want the cab to go back here, so the driver's seat will be quite far back. And then we'll have like the dog nose, and hopefully that'll look pretty good. So, let's go ahead and start building. Hey! Alright, so let's start by going into here and doing it symmetrically. Yes, that makes sense. We're then gonna go with these guys across the front end like this, and I'm actually gonna go ahead and build this up like that. There we go. This is gonna be quite a big thing. At least I think so, anyway. I'm gonna do something along those lines. From there, I'm thinking we do something like this, so it actually gets built up once more, just like that. And we'll build these guys across to each other, just like this. Yeah, you know what, actually, that makes sense. From there, we can just go ahead and send this down like this, all the way back to there. Alright, does that look weird? I think it looks a little bit weird. If we then extend these guys backwards from there like this, I guess it's fine, but at the same time, it is a little bit strange. It doesn't look quite right. Okay, so what I'm going to do instead is actually have it be relatively flat on the front, and hopefully that'll look okay. I think it will. So, let's go with... What if one of these was on the front? I don't know. I'm just coming up with ideas to try and make it look a bit nicer. If we went with those, would that be strange? I guess it kind of would be, but I think it would also sort of work. So we'd, like, attach these guys together right here like this. There you go. We'd have the grill actually fit in there and work properly. And then hopefully everything else would work too, maybe. Okay, so the thing that's actually getting me is obviously the engine isn't actually in this front compartment. It is actually down below where I guess it should be, but like, you know what I mean. So let's get rid of this down to here again. And I actually kind of want this to come out to the fender a little bit. We'll delete this guy and these guys, and I'm going to do this. So it's actually going to come outwards just once. Yeah, that makes sense to me. Alright, cool. Another thing that actually makes some sense to me is this. If I build that up like that, maybe I'll actually do this with 1x2s. That might look nicer. So let's do that like that. There we go, very good. We'll then send this in, and maybe that looks okay? Maybe it doesn't. I don't know. Let me know in the comments down below what you guys think of like a flat front end. I think that'll be fine. We can then go with like these guys. On here, kind of like this. Oh, kind of like this. And we'll send it across, and hopefully that'll look okay. Bosh. Yeah, no, I think that is actually fine. From there, we can go backwards like this. We can have this go outwards like that. There we go. Shove this guy under here like this. And yeah, that actually seems pretty good. Pretty good indeed. Yeah, so whack that on there. There we go. Send these guys in with each other. And spawn it in. How big is that? You know what? That actually looks pretty good from here. Cool. Okay, so I want something that looks a little bit like a bull bar. So let's go to rockets. Here we go. And we are actually going to start by deleting these guys and doing this. And I'm also going to go ahead and shove some of these guys onto here like this. 1, 2, and 3. There we go. Shove that straight into there. And I kind of want this to go across here like this. Going to delete this because that's where the vent is. Actually, you know what? Let's put these here as well. There we go. Do that. Shove this guy into there. Delete this guy. Delete this. And delete this one as well. Grab this in white and put it on there like this. What do you guys think of that? So we can actually see the air vent. The air vent. I don't know. That looks a bit weird to me. Looks a little bit strange. Although, what if we just put like a pipe across so that it looks like we're protecting it, kind of. You know, like this? I think that's okay. I don't want this piece here, so I'm going to get rid of it. And there we go. Alright, cool. Let's see what that looks like. And then we'll build the rest of it from there. That looks okay. I might put a bit of a grill thing here as well. With paint blocks, but we'll see. Okay, something else that we also sort of want to deal with is fenders. I actually do want some fenders on this thing. So I was going to build these guys out like this. There we go. And I was going to build these guys backwards, obviously. But I don't know how I'm going to fit them all in. So obviously that's going to have to come down like this. We'll attach that straight into there like that. These guys, however, I'm not sure what I'm going to do here. I'm thinking I just do this. Or maybe we do that and this. Ah, this will work. There we go, good. And then this piece, I think I could just leave sort of open. That's fine. There we go, let's have a little look at this. Yeah, that looks pretty good to me. Cool. Okay, so from there, what do we do? Well, I'm going to go ahead and fix this bit into here like this. Realistically, I would like to make this come further backwards, but we're not really going to do that. Let's go and send these guys together, and I don't know, if the deck or the floor was here, we can't really fit seats in there, not really. So it'd actually have to go up by one. And if the seat was in there, would that look strange if the seats were here? You know what I mean? Maybe not. Maybe not. It's going to look wild, but at the same time, I think that's fine. So if we put this in here like this, we then build in some actual seats, like these ones, I think this could be okay, which is really, really weird. But yeah, I think that'll be fine. So paste these in here like this. We'll actually put some backs on those, and that'll look great. All right, so this is what it currently looks like. It's a little bit strange, but I think it looks sort of the way that I wanted it to look originally. I wouldn't mind if these seats are a little bit further down. However, I don't really care for it that much. Another thing that I do want to do is I want some windshield, if I can. But I feel like that's going to be a little bit annoying. I might just do it with one of these. Like, I don't know. I guess like this sort of thing, but not really. I don't know. Because I feel like they get a little bit chunky and that looks a little bit strange sometimes. You know, like that would be really cool, but it also looks very chunky. I don't know. I don't know what to go with here. Maybe, or maybe we don't actually go with a roof at all, and maybe we just go with a windshield. But even that is annoying. Alright, so I'm gonna grab this guy on this side, so there we go. And those guys, let's go ahead and cut this and move it backwards just by like two. Yeah. Alright, by two, there we go. Paste that in there. Merge this and shove this bit further backwards as well. There you go. And now the windscreen could come either further backwards or start further forwards. So it could go here still. There you go. And it won't look so weird because we can still see out the sides. You see? All right, good. Yeah, that can be fine. And then we can actually have the back end and we can have a roof if we want one. Hey! Who thought that was a good idea? Me! All right, good. So if we shove this under here like this and we attach this guy onto there like that, we should be able to go straight across the top, like so. I can't really add windows, unfortunately, but we can add a roof, and we can add a rear. Hey! I guess that's somewhat fine, but, like, not really. I don't know how I feel about this. Windows. Let's go windows next. 2x3, let's go ahead and shove that onto there like this, and we'll shove these guys onto here like this. There you go. All right, let's spawn this in and see what that looks like. Yeah, you see, it looks a little bit too high, doesn't it? I think so. All right, so if I was to lower it down, we'd actually have to build these guys into here like this. There you go. And then have a bit of a flat roof and just do that instead. This guy is a little bit annoying. We just have to go one of these. And I would say that probably looks a hell of a lot better. So let's delete this. Get ourselves a new window. Shove it in even lower. Here we go. Make it black. There you go. Shove this in. Grab one of these guys. Shove it on there. Delete this. Send it across. And spawn that in. Now that it's lower, it should look a lot better. Which indeed it does. That's sick. I'm actually extremely pleased with the way this is currently looking. Obviously, we're not going to have any glass. And that is a little bit annoying. But the rest of it seems fine. Okay, so if we were now to do some doors, let's go ahead and figure that out. Let's get ourselves some pivots. Here we go. And we will be shoving those pivots on here like this. Like that. There you go. I'm then going to delete four. And then I'm going to shove four on here. There we go. We're going to delete four again, but the bottom one is going to be one of these. So this one is going to be like this. There you go. And then we're going to delete three. So do three. And I guess that's actually it. There you go. So hopefully that'll actually fit in there. Let's go ahead and put a button on this door. Two-sided, so we can actually get in and out. There we go. And attach it to a switch box, and hopefully this'll work. Maybe. I'm also going to delete this guy and replace it with one of these. And I'm going to shove this on here like this. There we go. I'm also going to seal off the inside so that we don't have that problem. Good. Yeah, so far, this seems okay. Let's get some switch boxes and make this work. So, switch box. Shove it straight in here like this. Actually, we could totally just block this off with a switch box. Hey, there you go. So attach that up to there. Attach that one up to there. This one goes to the button. Out to the sides. There you go. And this one goes to this button. We then need electricity, obviously. Oh, wow. Nothing has electricity in here yet. Let's attach all these guys together. There we go. And these guys as well. Okay. These guys don't need no, you know what? They actually do. They do need some electricity. There we go. Fantastic. We also need an actual battery putting somewhere. So I'm going to put two batteries in. One here and one on the other side. There we go. Some actual batteries have been installed. Very good. All right, cool. So now that we've got those, off value is going to be minus one. On value is going to be 0.7. We're going to do the same on the other side. So minus one, 0.7. There we go. Spawn that in. Let's see what that does. There you go. So the doors automatically close. If we want to open them, we just push this button. Oh, they go a bit far. They go a bit far. It's actually minus 0.5. No, wait, no. Minus 0.7. No, that's not right. Minus 0.3. Hey, I think that's right. There you go. So minus 0.3. So the doors only open a little bit. All right, here we go. Bosh. There you go. And now we can jump in and we can close the door. And that's fine. We can see quite a lot out of here. It looks pretty good. I'm actually pretty pleased with the way this looks. And I'm happy with it. So what I'm going to do now is attach all of it together, make it work, and we'll drive it around a little bit. Okay, so I've gone ahead and put a key and a throttle lever in here. The throttle is going to go to the engine. There you go. And the clutch is going to be controlled via W and S. The steering is going to be controlled via here. I don't know. Did I put an inverter in here? I did. So I'm assuming that's all good. There we go. And now it should, presumably, actually work. There you go. Because that's going to turn on the radiator at the front. And also the engine. And this is actually for some headlights, which we don't currently have. And I kind of need some. So I don't know where they should go. I don't know where the headlights should go at all, actually. Because I kind of wanted to put one here. But I think that'd be weird. Would that be weird if I just like shoved a spotlight in? Like this? Maybe? But also, it kind of looks kind of cool. I don't know. What do you guys think? Does that look cool or does it look weird? There you go. I've tried to put it in normally. That's good. Let's go ahead and shove this one in as well. And we'll connect those guys straight up to this button right here. And the electricity, of course. There you go. All of these guys need electricity too. So do this and this guy. Hey! Alright, cool. Spawn that in. Let's go ahead and see if we can actually drive this thing around. Open up the door. There we go. Run around to the other side. Get inside. Here we go. Yes. Do the key. Alright, engine should start. Throttle up. And go. Alright, steering is inverted again. And I have stalled. It sort of works, but it sort of has issues as well. You know? I thought I put the driving on sticky, but I guess not. Right, okay, let's go ahead and invert the steering straight away so that we can fix that. This obviously goes down to there, and this goes up to here. That's fine. So the steering is now sort of fixed. I guess if I put a clamp on the throttle, we can make it so it doesn't stall out. Let's try that. That might be a good idea, actually. So let's put the clamp right in here. We can delete this and this. There we go. Clamp could go right in the center for now. That's okay. Clamp will go to the clutch. And this will go to W and S. And the max value we'll put on there is minus. Oh, actually, 0.3. Something like that. It should still move, and it should still move pretty quickly, but I'm not sure. So, let's get in. Turn the engine on. Throttle up. Let it rev a little bit, and then go. Yeah, this is slow. This is very slow, and it still stalls it out. So, I've never used a flywheel before. I'm assuming a flywheel should make this work better than it currently does. A few of you guys said just put it at the back. I don't know if it actually matters in Stormworks, does it? I don't think so. But what I'm going to do, because I can, is just add more add more cylinders. We can fit them in. We might as well use them. So let's just do it. There you go. Another cylinder there, and another cylinder there. That is a lot more cylinders added to our engine. But it should be fine. So do this and this. Go. There you go. Steering is a massive pain in the butt, but this speed is actually sort of okay. That's good. And it totally works. Yeah. But yeah, steering in this game with half tracks is stupid. They don't really work very well because the tracks sort of provide too much thrust, and then the front wheels don't get any like traction whatsoever, so you can't really steer, which is really annoying. But if you go slow enough, it does sort of work, which is so cool. Look at that. We're off-roading right now, and it's sort of dealing with it quite well. That's awesome. Nice. Okay, the last thing that I'm going to try today then is actually putting in a window. I kind of want to use this and just have them angle. I think that would be pretty sick. However, I would like a really straight piece all the way across, but that's not going to be a thing, is it? So I might just have to put a pivot in here and have them fold. Okay, so there we go. We shipped some windows in there, and now it actually has glass. I kind of would prefer maybe an XML edited window in there, but as it stands, this is sort of okay. I can deal with that. That's all right. So yeah, what do you guys think of the cab so far? Do you like it? Do you like the whole thing? Does it look cool? The next thing we'll probably add is the crane, and then we'll add a bunch of details after that to make it look a little bit better. But overall, I think this is pretty cool. What do you guys think? But for now, thanks for watching. See you next time. Goodbye.